Yeah. You're really selling it, aren't you?
Try one, just the one for today.
So here you go, one thing.
Thank you,
for
sweetie.
You.
Little circle in the middle is the jelly. If you like black licorice and mint.
Guys, let's go now on Sarah's favorite Croatian snack.
Hi everyone, I'm Sarah, a Canadian expat here in Croatia.
Hi, I'm Ivan. I'm Croatian.
Local.
Local, not expat.
Today we're going to give you the iconic snacks and candy, kind of. Really popular ones from Ivan's childhood.
Yes.
And that are still popular today. And there's no better way to get to know a culture than by trying their food, trying their snacks. So we're going to walk you through that today.
Let's go. First one is this one.
505. So it says here with a line.
Yeah.
So what is the line?
Oh, but you see it in the candy.
I know, but like, is it a different flavor inside the candy?
It's magic.
I've never tried these before. I'm not a huge fan of, I guess, these kind of hard candies. I don't know. There are many different flavors.
Oh, this is such an old candy. Let's try. It's hard candy, so you cannot chew it.
It's okay. It says with plant extracts and natural aromas. Okay. Like a regular hard candy.
Yeah.
I'd give it a 7.
7.
Mm-hmm. I feel like this is something you'd find at like a Croatian grandma's coffee table on like a little glass
exactly.
dish. Is that right?
Yeah, exactly. Next is also, it's Bronhi.
It's toffee kind of.
Yeah,
right?
It's toffee candy. Mm-hmm. And, also, when I was a kid, this was the favorite candy of older people because it says bronchi, you breathe easier or like, how to say
so it? Like helps your bronchis
yes,
or something?
Yes, basically. I don't know for sure. Would she like this one?
I've never actually tried these. I don't think I'm going to like them.
It's very popular here, so.
Okay, it looks different than I thought it was going to look.
Yeah. You know what? When you eat this candy, it will stick a little bit on your teeth.
Probably a lot.
So
I don't think I'm going to like this, but I'm going to try it.
Well, you have to try it.
At all. Black licorice. If you like black licorice and mint, together. If you like black licorice and mint, then you'll be a fan.
I know, it's just like something like mentally, like eucalyptus.
It's like a mint. Yeah, it's more minty now.
Yeah.
I'm not getting as much black licorice anymore.
Yeah, it's minty. Yeah.
It changes into mint. Strange.
Can you breathe easier? Yeah.
Okay. It got better as I kept chewing it.
Mm-hmm.
But I still probably wouldn't choose a mint toffee. I would give this maybe a 6 out of 10.
6?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Mm.
That's
not bad,
not
right? I thought I was not going to like that at all. And so it turned out to be okay.
It's also very popular chocolate when I was a kid, and also having it this time.
People still really like
it. Yeah, it's called Mikado. It says here it is like first in the world rice chocolate. So
first rice chocolate in the world.
Yeah.
Okay.
You don't have this kind of chocolate.
I mean, I've never had it before. Moved to Croatia. I've tried this before, but it's fine, you'll see what it looks like.
Lots of rice inside and like this.
Yeah, they don't break well.
Yeah. It's kind of hard. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, so you can see kind of up close. It's kind of just filled with rice and then it's covered in chocolate. I think a lot of people probably eat this because I feel like it's a bit healthier. Like it's a bit of a healthier chocolate because it's basically just like a bunch of rice surrounded by chocolate.
Mm. That is delicious. I like this.
Mm. I could eat it if I had to. I don't know. I'm not the biggest fan of it. The rice is too plain or something. It doesn't have any flavor. I don't know.
Yeah,
I don't like it that much.
Rice is rice, I mean.
I know. I just don't see the point. I just put some nuts in it or some cookies inside or something, but rice doesn't do it for me. So, I don't know. I'm going to give this maybe a 6 out of 10.
One of the also favorite, the most favorite, our kids.
Yeah, our kids
candy
love these.
Is Kiki.
I've tried them before. I haven't had them in a long time, but
it's basically candy with the fruits.
It's kind of like a Starburst show. Like, okay, so there are these different flavors. There is an orange, a lemon, a strawberry, a raspberry. And my kids are obsessed with these. I don't love them, but I'm going to try one for you just to show you what it is. So yeah, like they're kind of like a Starburst, but the colors and flavors are just a bit more natural. Like they're not so crazy, bright, artificial. And I think they taste a little less artificial than Starburst too. So that's a plus. But I don't really love the kind of chewy candies like this.
Also, I mean, now they're not my favorite, definitely. And I'm all adult.
Yeah.
Probably I liked them when I was a kid, but I noticed our kids, Kiki is the best.
My love
mom,
them.
They always have for them one Kiki.
When we're on our way out, they like put one secretly in their pockets.
Yeah.
And they're really happy.
So let's try. Also sticks on your teeth.
Mm-hmm. It's a chewy candy. It's a chewy, fruity candy.
Yeah.
What else can you say?
What's your verdict?
I would give it maybe a six. Because I just don't like the kind of fruity, chewy candies, but it wasn't terrible.
Now, one of my favorites still, chocolate bars. It's called
rum
bars?
Squares, kind of.
Yeah, or bars. And I think Sarah never tried.
I've never tried this
because
I just
she doesn't
never
like rum.
Yeah, I don't like rum flavored stuff that much, and so yeah. I've never tried it.
And they have like inside like some gelée or
some jelly.
Jelly, yeah.
Like a rum jelly.
Yeah.
You're really selling it, aren't you?
And they're really good. So here you go, one thing
for you. Thank
you,
sweetie. I thought it was going to be like more of like an actual jelly. It's more of like a soft, not even toffee, but.
They're so good. They're so rummy.
You can see inside.
You have that word, rummy.
Sure. But not as bad as I actually thought they would be. Yeah, they have a nice flavor. They're very sweet.
Oh, very sweet.
Very sweet. Mm-hmm. I would probably give this one a 7 out of 10. But they're very soft.
Nice.
Very soft and chewy. Are you satisfied with that?
Yeah. It's surprising. I thought that we want to give 4.
It's not bad. It's actually better than I thought. So maybe I should have tried it sooner. But I would probably never buy one for myself. And I'll probably never eat this again in my life. But for you.
For me, this is number one. I just like rum and everything. Cakes.
He's not an alcoholic. Rum flavor, he means, not actually.
Yeah, flavor. Next one is Zivotinjsko Carstvo, which is the animal kingdom. Just like regular milk chocolate, which was very popular and still popular with our kids too.
And yeah, our kids love these things.
Yeah, because when you open it, you also get something inside instead of chocolate. Chocolate is just like...
So yeah, here's the chocolate, what that looks like.
And what else you get, which is very popular with kids.
So you get a sticker. Kids really like to collect these, and then they can put them in an album.
It's very thin.
Mm-hmm. I've tried these before. I really like them. Just like a little thin piece of milk chocolate.
Yeah.
It's delicious.
Milk.
There's really not much else to say about it. So I would say maybe like 9 out of 10.
Ooh, that's good.
Mm-hmm. I don't know. Kras has really nice chocolate.
It's just like simple.
Simple little piece of milk chocolate if that's what you're looking for. Our kids would be really mad that we're doing this video today because we're eating like all their favorite snacks too. And they're not here doing it with us.
Yeah. It's called Bananko.
A banana middle with a light, like a really thin
like
chocolate coating. I have tried these before, mainly because even when I were first dating, he said that they're wonderful. Like, try them, they're really good.
I
was like, okay, yeah, I believe you. And they are not my favorite. I don't know. I'm going to try it for this video, but...
One more thing, Bananko from Kras is the best. There are so many companies making this Bananko, but from Kras, the best. Just like the taste, the most natural.
Like, I won't even finish this whole bite. I don't like these. I knew that I didn't like them. It's basically like, it's not even a marshmallow. It's like a softer, kind of gritty almost. Very, very sweet. It's terrible.
What's your verdict? Don't like give them give verdict.
Maybe I shouldn't even give a grade to this one. I'm sorry, Kras. You have so many amazing products, but this is just. No.
For me, this is like 10 of 10. Okay, next one. We are going on cookies.
Okay, I like cookies.
Sarah likes cookies.
Yeah. So, I like most of the cookies here. Most.
Moto. This is a tea cookies with.
Yeah, it's like, I mean, sure, it can be tea cookies. They're like little sandwich cookies. They're delicious. One side is vanilla, kind of, and the other side is chocolate. I'll show you. So this side is white, and this side is dark, and then it has just a chocolate filling inside. These are delicious. I love these, and they're one of Ethan's favorite cookies. And they're the best when you just open the pack, and they're super fresh.
And yes, and then you dip in the coffee, and oof.
I love these.
Yeah.
I'm going to give it a 10 right away. Mm-hmm. But I knew that before.
It's quality. It's quality.
Yeah. It's not like a cheap.
Yeah, it's not cheap. Mm. Guys, let's go now on Sarah's favorite Croatian snack. Tortica.
Yay!
This is the best.
Yeah. I love these.
Mine is it's okay. I mean, I like it too, but it's not my favorite.
Yeah, so delicious. So basically, it's like a wafer that's coated in chocolate with like chocolate filling between each wafer, and they're super like thin layers and just delightful. They are so good. It's just like a.
It's also fluffy.
Very fluffy, like light kind of crispy wafer.
It's not over chocolatey.
Yeah, and it's dark chocolate. Yeah. It's delicious.
It's a little
light. Mm-hmm. I would give this more than 10. So it's great.
It's your favorite, definitely. Mm. Probably the most popular Croatian cookies.
Yes.
And they are Napolitanke.
Mm-hmm. I love these.
Wafers. They're wafers, chocolate wafers.
These ones are chocolate cream inside, but you can get many other flavors.
Yeah, you can get like nougat, mocha, different, but chocolate is
the best. And also when they're fresh, same thing, right out of the pack.
Oh, look at this.
We could really like crush through a whole kilo of these.
Sarah, when she came here in Croatia, she knew it to eat them so much that she would get sick.
No, like I could not stop. They're like chips. Like,
I was kind of like worried for her because like it was like too much sweets.
You know? No, honestly, like when you start eating these, I know. Yeah. But when you start eating them, you cannot stop. Like they're so good and they're so addicting. Like it's dangerous to even have them in the house because
you
it's
can
so
eat them
easy.
With the milk. You can dip in the milk. You can dip in the
coffee.
Coffee,
tea anything basically.
Yeah, try one, just the one for today. But Napolitanke, I think they are there's not number one in the world.
Can't compare. So, like I would say in the world, actually. You can just see all the little layers just perfectly put together. Chocolate cream inside. You can't go wrong. So good. Now put those away or I'll just crush through. It's kind of similar to an arrowroot cookie. It's just kind of like a nice little butter cookie. And like they're nice and thin and I think they taste better than an arrowroot. So I really like these. I eat these almost every day with coffee and...
And our kids also like them. And they're not so bad. They're not so sweet. They're not chocolatey.
They're just kind of simple biscuits. Yeah. I really like them. Our kids love them. Actually, it's one of the first like cookies we give our kids, too. Because they're just very kind of a plain biscuit. And all of our kids love them. Light and fluffy. And delicious. Just a really nice... Simple biscuit. Plain old biscuit.
Yeah.
For a score, I would give this one
a
10 because I just like it and I eat them very often.
I wouldn't say 10 because, I don't know,
there's nothing special to them maybe. Yeah. But, you know, sometimes plain things are the best.
But it was funny when I was a kid, I eat them on some like really, really special way because I like them a lot. You would have hot milk in your...
So even just heated up some milk now, and this is a cup full of hot milk.
So you would just like put a bunch of them inside. That would be like a really well your breakfast, like sweet breakfast.
Healthy breakfast.
Yeah. So like you dip them inside and it seemed like put a bunch of them. And then you kinda like just like squish them inside.
You kinda wait for them to melt.
Yeah, they melt really quickly.
They really do melt quickly.
So you got like this kind of like stew.
Soup.
Basically soup.
A cookie soup.
Cookie soup, yeah. Mmm. Okay.
Yeah.
Mmm. It's delish. Now it's still delish.
I see. Yeah, I mean, it's not bad.
It
just tastes
so
like you dip
good.
Cookies in milk and...
Yeah, just like mixed inside.
But all mixed together. Yeah. It's
like...
Not bad.
Cookie soup. My favorite. It's called Rondo C.
Okay, so I like these. I've tried them before and I like them. They're not my favorite, but I'll eat them once in a while. They say with vitamin C, so they're healthy.
You're right.
But it says that they're flavored like a pineapple kind of flavor.
Yeah, pineapple flavor. Yeah.
Which I wouldn't even like, I don't know, if I didn't read that, I wouldn't think that they're pineapple flavored.
Yeah, it's
would
kind
you?
Of like blowing.
Yeah.
You don't taste so much pineapple.
I wouldn't say that they're pineapple, but okay, if
but
the packaging says so.
I was killing them when I was kidding.
You
like,
still kill them, did
I? Yeah, I still eat them. So yeah, they look like a little like pill, or I'd say.
Yeah, they do, they do,
yeah.
It's kind of actually like, kind of like a Tums almost,
yeah,
but less
yeah.
chalky,
yeah.
more like they're harder.
Ah, you can also like, chew them.
Yeah.
They're not super hard.
I
like,
chew them, but
505.
If he even has one of these packs, the whole thing will be gone in like.
Oh, I kill them like in like half an hour.
Yeah, they're all yeah. They're meant to be, you know, they sit in your purse or something.
Yeah,
you
yeah,
have
yeah.
one once in a while, but not with even.
No, not even refreshing your like bread.
No,
like,
no,
you know.
It's just like a candy. Yeah, but you
so,
love them. They're okay. I like them. I would give them an 8 because they're not bad. They're just I don't
no,
know.
It's okay.
Yeah,
no, that's good grade.
Yeah.
But,
not bad.
Yeah, for me, 10 of 10. Okay, next candy, Vau Vau, which means in Croatian, we say Vau Vau for woof woof.
It's how a dog barks in
yes,
Croatian.
It's basically a dog house. Yeah, look at it.
Oh, it actually opens like a little door.
Oh,
that's
yeah.
cute. That's really
yeah,
cute.
It's like, it was like, it was cute for kids.
Yeah, that's really cute.
And they're basically dogs.
Oh, they're little
puppies.
Puppies. Oh, very hard. Mmm. They're pez.
Mm, yeah, kind of pets.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
They're good. They're good.
Yeah.
Good.
I mean, I just don't eat candy, so.
Yeah.
But I'm sure I would have loved these as a kid.
Mm-hmm.
Really cute. I'd probably give it an 8 because they're tasty and they're not, like, overpowering.
Yeah.
Like, they're not bad.
They're good.
Yeah. Okay, I'd give it an 8. Probably I would give it higher if I was a kid and liked to eat lots of candy, but.
Now we will try Croatian cookies, which Sarah doesn't like, but I like it. I don't eat them so often, but they're very popular. They're called Jaffa.
I don't even want to try this, really.
Yes, you will try because you have to do the score. Like soft cookies with like orange jelly.
Mm-hmm. Little circle in the middle is the jelly.
Like orange jelly.
An orange jelly that sits on top of the cookie, and I really like. I'm not excited to try this, but I'm going to.
Let's try. Mm. Mm. It's good. It's good. They're good cookies.
Ugh, I just like don't like the orange jelly part. Like without the
orange
jelly, I don't like orange and chocolate together. So I'm sure if you like orange and chocolate together, you would like this. You can also take off the jelly. And that would be a better way of eating them. So look at this. Jelly's gone.
And you have like soft
and then
biscuit.
You have a nice soft biscuit. The biscuit's not bad and the chocolate's okay. Just this jelly part could totally do without. If I'm honest, it's not good. Maybe I shouldn't even give it a grade or a score. I think that it wouldn't even fall on the chart. So...
Oh boy.
Sorry.
Okay.
Like, it's
no,
just this does nothing
like,
for me, and I would be totally fine.
It's very
if I...
subjective because she doesn't like orange and anything chocolate, so.
It's true.
But they're really good. I would give them like 8 of 10, but I'm not like.
8?
Yeah.
You wouldn't give them a 9 or a 10.
No, I mean, they're not my favorite.
Oh,
cookies,
okay.
But...
Not my favorite. Not my favorite cookies, but lots of people like them. Tons of people like them. If you like orange, and chocolate and orange jelly, then you're surely gonna love these.
this is basically cookie.
Mm.
And it's, I would say, after Napolitanke, second most popular in Croatia.
And probably the second most delicious.
Yeah. Domacica.
Yeah, we tried these. I mean, we always buy them, so I've tried them a thousand times.
That's also, this is one of the gifts which you give to people if you go visit your grandma or, like some friends.
If you go over to some friend's house or for coffee, you can bring them a box of these cookies.
They're just like tea biscuits.
Just a really nice light biscuit with a nice dark chocolate.
It goes with coffee.
Tea.
Yeah, the best.
Whatever.
Yeah.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Delicious. What can I say?
Yeah.
Good?
Yeah. Bobi flips.
They're like a really nice, different kind of snack. If you don't feel like chips, you want something else, I don't know. They're like a little corn puff, and then they're just coated in kind of like a peanutty flavor. They're really soft inside. It's really, they're delicious. I'll show you, like, they just kind of break open easily. They're really good. We eat these often when we're watching a movie or something. They're really, really good. I would give these a 9 out of 10. They're really good.
Good.
Last one.
Last actually snack. It's also salty one, called saltas from Keestlin. Show you how they look. They're pretzel sticks.
Just pretzel stick, just regular.
With it says here with sea salt.
Mm-hmm.
We don't go to travel without them.
No.
For kids, for us,
mm-hmm.
this is like good thing to
true
to keep kids calm in.
It's a staple when we travel. Absolutely, yeah. In the car, everywhere. So nothing much to say about them. They're just pretzel sticks, and they're really good. I like them because they're really thin and just really crispy and
salty too.
And salty. Maybe give it a 10.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, for pretzel sticks.
Yeah, because they're just like a nice,
simple,
light, simple snack.
Yeah.
I mean, so now we just tried how many snacks? Maybe like 15.
Oh,
that wraps up our snack presentation for you. Everything we just tried now, what's your favorite?
Maybe like a Rum Plocice or a Rum bars.
I'm sure you know what my favorite is.
Your favorite is Bronhi. Your favorite is Tortica.
Kid, when you were a kid, what was your absolute favorite out of everything?
When I was a kid, maybe I'd say Rondo C.
Rondo C, when you were a kid, really?
Yeah, I like those hard candies when I was a kid, so.
Okay, so I hope that you enjoyed experiencing all these Croatian snacks. I'll put a list in the description of all of the snacks that we tried. I'll put them in order also, and then you can reference them. This will just kind of give you like a
good
selection
idea.
Of
what to try.
Okay, so we really hope that you enjoyed this video and you learned a thing or two about true Croatian snacks.
Let us know
in the comments below if you guys want us to do another video trying other kinds of products. We'd love it if you would subscribe to our channel, and then you can join us for exploring more food, culture, places, cities, all around Croatia. Okay, we hope to see you guys again really soon.
Bye.